welcome to Paula Duffy, Woman's Guide to Football, How to Talk His Language. I'm your host and coach for this fun look at the game of professional football. I've followed sports my whole life. It was a family activity encouraged by my dad, and it helped me form a strong bond that still exists between my brother and me. And it set me up for ways to relate to boys and men. It gave me ways to understand what winning and losing really mean in the game of life. I had advantages in business settings, being able to talk sports with male colleagues and bosses. I could attend games, talk to business clients, and I could have a refuge. Yes, a refuge for the saddest and loneliest times in my life. They are just games, but if you enjoy them, know the backstories of the personalities and pick a team to follow, you have a best friend for life. Now, you might be listening because you're a sports widow and tired of not spending time with the sports fan in your life. Or you might want to be able to talk sports at work with men you know or want to know. You might want to give up on the monthly fee from internet dating sites, which promise you the world and deliver photos of men you'd never be interested in anyway. Whatever your reason, I'm thrilled you're here, so let's get started. Professional football is truly a simple game that gets complicated with many details you really don't need to learn the game and talk the lingo. It's just like anything else. You know, like learning to cook. There's your basic meal of some broiled chicken, baked potato, and a salad, and then there's chicken cordon bleu. What we got here is broiled chicken, so don't be afraid. Football's lure to men and women fans is its raw power, its emphasis on achievement almost at all costs, and the fact that the only thing that can hold you back from getting a touchdown is your own inability to get past the other team or an injury. Its appeal stems from the fact that in your real life, most times, there are other people and factors that inhibit you from getting ahead, even when you're at your best. A friend of mine likes to say that in the corporate world, the politics and other people's egos can keep you from getting to the goal line to score a touchdown. That's why we love sports. It's just people demonstrating who's better on that particular day or season with no one else to undermine them. This coaching session will help you understand how a game begins and ends, basic rules and info on the players and what they do, some terms used by the announcers when they describe what's going on, and then how to use what you've learned to talk sports. You see, sports fans have to talk about it. Otherwise, it's almost like it didn't happen. It's like that old chestnut, if a tree falls in the forest and there's no one around to hear it, does it make a sound? Why else would you be inundated with sports talk shows on radio and TV? You know how men think that women have to talk about everything and they think they don't? Well, if you know how to talk sports, you'll quickly learn that's a lie. They don't want to talk about how they feel. They want to talk about how other people feel. Yes, that's right. They'll talk about feelings if they are those of a coach or player. They'll use phrases like, he's not getting the respect he deserves. Or, what was he thinking when he called that play? Shocking, isn't it? But true. Men will talk and talk and talk if it's about sports. Football games begin with a coin toss. Like any good host would, the team which is playing in its own stadium is called the home team and allows its guests, the visiting team, to call heads or tails. The winner of the toss gets to choose if it wants to start by going on offense or defense. Almost 100% of the time, the winner wants to go on offense and see if they can score first. It sets a tone, and it puts the other team under pressure immediately. In other words, it puts them on the defensive. And that's what two of the squads on a football team are called, offense and defense. There's another squad on a football team. That's called special teams. They include the men who kick the ball on one team and catch it on the other. Sometimes they're just called the kicking squad. The winner of the coin toss, who chooses to go on offense first, puts his special teams squad out on the field to receive the football, which is kicked by the other team. The football has a nickname, a pigskin. That was what the original footballs were made from. Today, footballs are made of leather, just like the car seat you're sitting in. Anyway, back to the kick. That particular kick is called the kickoff. The ball is placed on a plastic tee on the field, and the kicker runs up to the ball, kicks it as the other members of his squad head down the field to keep the receiver from either catching the kickoff or, if he catches the ball, keep him from running too far with it. The guy who catches the ball has the rest of his own special team around him.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.